I'm Andrea Bruder, and I'm Chair of Mathematics and Computer Science here at Colorado College. I invited some of my colleagues in the sciences to talk to you about how the block plan changes the way we approach teaching math and science here at CC. Let's start with Professor Barnes from Environmental Science.
Hi, yeah, so when I got to Colorado College 6 years ago, I was really excited that this presented the opportunity, the block plan that is, to take my students to where I do research, because I think it's really important that we can not only teach students the mechanics of our topic or our study area, but also teach them about how science is done. Most students, right, coming into college have learned science as a set of facts while they learn art as a process. And I think on the block, we can really embrace the amount of time we have and the flexibility to share that process with them. And so I get to take my students in our intro class to climate change, it's intro to global climate change, to Niwot Ridge, which is the picture behind me. And this is a long-term ecological research site at about 10,000 feet outside of Boulder, Colorado. And students get to see how we're studying climate in the present, and they, more importantly, also get to meet the scientists who are doing it and see how that science gets done. And I think that that sort of complete experience is really hard if we only had an hour every other day in the classroom.
Let's ask Professor Siddoway from Geology. How does the block plan open up the Rocky Mountain West for your students?
Something I really enjoy about teaching in the block schedule and close to mountain and geology sources is I get to teach students to read. Many of them know how to go to sources in the form of literature or books, and more are very attached to their cell phones as a source of information. But first sources that geologists use are rocks, like this one that has a striking geometrical pattern of lines, or this one, another favorite. So it's sort of shifting the eye, training the observation to read rocks firsthand in nature, and many times in a collaborative way working outdoors.
Let's hear from Professor Perramond in Environmental Science and Southwest Studies.
Thanks, Andrea. Yeah, one of the great joys of teaching on the block is that we don't have the semester trap. We're traditionally a lab period once a week for 3 hours. And so being able to engage multiple hours a day or for an entire week on site in the Southwest at high elevation near a lake at some road exposure is really one of the great joys of teaching on the block because it's unconstrained by the sort of the traditional orthodoxy of semester time. And it's really a great pleasure to be able to have either landscapes to read, in the case as Dr. Siddoway was talking about, or actual elements to read, as Dr. Barnes was discussing when it comes to particular chemistry or biochemistry. For my own sake, it's about the primary observation of landscape, livelihoods, and what people do, and the sort of environmental justice components too in the Southwest, which are vital to my interests in water resources. So it's been a great format to be able to teach on. It's eminently flexible.
And let's close with Professor Grover from Chemistry and Biochemistry.
So one of the things that's good about teaching on the block plan is that our class sizes are small, even in our introductory classes. So that means organic classes and biochemistry classes are small. Students are very engaged and they're super excited to work in groups. They go work on the board. They research articles, they lead and participate in discussions, which makes the class very interactive and hands-on, and that allows them to be fully engaged in learning the material. And when we learn something new, we learn about infrared spectroscopy, we walk to the lab and do it. We can decide today is the day for protein extraction. So there's no need to have a very same kind of day every day. Each day is different. And it depends on what they're learning, where they are, that allows us to tailor the class to them. And that makes it fun for students and for us.
We had a similar hands-on experience in my math class in Block 2 back in October in the days before COVID-19 when students used mathematical software to model the spread of different epidemics. We looked at everything from measles to influenza. And quite recently, those same students asked me if the models they had been studying in class were applicable to the current situation, and the answer was absolutely. So that's what smaller class and intensity of the block plan can produce. That's Colorado College. Thanks, everyone, and thank you for listening. See you all in the fall.
Nice to see you. Bye.